on a cold early November afternoon. We're having a couple of hours in the sunshine, and I want to try and empty one of these compost bins so that we can start filling it up again. This is the one I'd like to empty. The material's now rotted down. It's been in here a couple of years. It's ready to be cleared out and go on one of our other beds. The problem is there are some bindweed roots in, and I do have to be careful that I get them all out. It's a close-up of those horrible white roots that are bindweed. Fortunately, they're easy to spot in the dark coloured compost, so I just remove them, leave them in a pile, and they go home and into the recycling bin. While I was busy sorting out this compost heap, Sue was weeding round our autumn fruiting raspberries, all gold. This bed was refurbished earlier in the year, and we're trying to look after it, keep it well maintained. I've moved four barrowfuls, so I've cleared about half of this compost heap. I've now got space on the left hand side to move all this dry stuff on top that's not composted down yet over to the left hand side, and that'll be the bottom layer that can start composting for next time. We might not get one down the plot, but it doesn't mean we have to go without a cup of coffee. The only difference is we'll probably drink it sitting in the shed rather than outside. Got to go now, kettle's boiling. So I've got it emptied. I've got some lovely barrowfuls of compost out of there that's been spread over the raspberries and some rhubarb. I've a bed ready for next year. So now I've spread all the dry stuff out on the bottom of this one that will form the base. And we'll just be piling rubbish on top of this now for 12 months or so before it's left, just to rot down. So I've just got a post to hammer in now to hold this pallet in place. I was most disappointed bonfire night on last night to see all those pallets that could be recycled being burnt on bonfires. What an absolute waste. Hopefully that'll be fine for a couple of years. We'll find out. So we're not going to put any more compost on this heap, so I'm going to just see if I can level the top off and then see if I can cover it with some weed control fabric just to keep it a little bit warmer, hopefully help it rot down a bit quicker. At least this end of the compost pile's looking a bit tidier now. I've still got the rest of it to really sort out. This might be a bit tricky because although the time is only 3:15, the sun's just going to fall behind that row of trees at the back of the plot. That's why it's always colder down here in winter. The sun disappears mid-afternoon. As you can see, having cleared this out, it leaves us lots of space for composted material. We'll use only proper grown materials. We won't put weeds or anything in here. It will just be what we take off the plot, like waste from vegetables and fruit trees. I think we have a plan that we might put some buddleia in the bottom. So this one's ready now, and we'll probably leave this at least till next year. We'll know when it's ready because it'll be vastly reduced in size. The only problem with this one is it looks as though I might lose the front part of it, but I'll deal with that when the time comes. I'll leave these piles like they are, dig them in next spring when the weed control fabric's all moved round by one plot on these four beds. Add enough compost to mulch around these summer raspberries. Just took one barrowful along this row. Once Sue had finished weeding round these autumn fruiting raspberries, these had some of that lovely compost spread around the roots as a mulch. Hopefully we'll get lots of juicy raspberries next autumn.